Get the latest local news anytime you want at WKBN.com. You're watching WKBN, 27 First News, where your news comes first. Now, in high definition.
Well, she's an Emmy award-winning TV host and best-selling author. And this morning, Rita Cosby joins us to talk about her new book, Quiet Hero. Good morning, Rita. How are you?
Good morning. It's great to be here, especially in Youngstown. This is such an amazing community, Polish community, too, which I love, so I feel at home.
Well, thank you for being here. And a lot of people know you from Fox News or MSNBC. You've written a book about Anna Nicole Smith. But you decided to do a little investigating of your own family. Is that right? Tell us about that.
This has truly been the most amazing journey of my life and truly the story of my life. Here I am. I'm an investigative journalist. I've interviewed the who's who. And I finally got to turn the tables and look into my own life. And what I've discovered is an incredible hero in my own backyard.
And
it was
your father.
My father. And my father never talked about it, Jeff. He was sort of one of those, I believe, very much like the Greatest Generation. Mm-hmm. Incredibly humble. Also, it was so painful for him because he lost so many comrades. But he was right on the front lines of the Polish resistance, thrust into the war, literally at the age of 13, fought on the front lines. And the stories of heroism with the Polish resistance are incredible. Fighting with, you know, sticks and Molotov cocktails against the most vicious war machine in the world. Mm-hmm. And then my dad was captured, taken to a POW camp, escaped, and at the end of the day, saved by American troops.
Wow. And you were saying that one of the things that led you to this was his dog tags. This is what made you start some of the mementos your mother kept around. Is that right?
Yeah. Suddenly, I opened a suitcase after my mother passed away, and I tell everybody, look at their suitcase, save these things. And inside, I essentially found my father's life. I found a rusty POW tag emblazoned with the word Stalag 4V, and then I found a card with code names on it. Mm-hmm. And also, I found a card of an ex-POW named Ryszard Kozabutski. And I tell everybody, but I'm glad my dad changed his name to Cosby, and I was born Cosby. Otherwise, it would have been Fox News Live with Rita Kozabutski,
right,
or Live and Direct with Rita Kozabutski. But it's been the most amazing journey to honor these veterans. And you, especially here in Youngstown, you have the War Memorial, which I know that they're looking at moving it to a much more appropriate place, to Poland, you know, here, the section Poland, of course, of Peterson Park and that area, which I think is so fantastic because we can never forget those who sacrificed so much. And the War Memorial, in fact, honoring those what of World War I and World War II, and Polish and American. And I think it is so important that we find appropriate places to honor our veterans and signify and give them dignity. And this is my way with this book to make sure that we honor those and to say thanks. And a part of the proceeds automatically go to wounded troops and their families, because at the end of the day, my father was 90 pounds and 6 feet tall when he escaped from prisoner war camp. Mm-hmm. He saw a plane come ahead. And when the plane was hovering, it turned out to be an American plane. And it dropped down a note. It was a chocolate bar with the note wrapped around it with the red ribbons, my favorite part of my dad's story. And it said, "Welcome, you're safe to walk now. 15 miles to walk and you're free."
Wow.
So my father wanted to give back and say thank you. I'm going to be in town. I'm also going to be at YSU today at DeBartolo Hall and speaking also to journalism students. It's open to the public, so I hope people come on out.
And how can people get the book if they want to get a copy of the book?
They can get a copy. It's on Amazon, Barnes & Noble's, Borders, all fine bookstores all across the country. And again, proceeds go not just to wounded troops, but also to museums in Poland. Mm-hmm. The Museum of the History of Polish Jews, where the Warsaw Ghetto once stood, because my father was about 200 yards from the ghetto, and also the Warsaw Rising Museum, honoring incredible heroics of the Polish resistance. Because my father said, "I'm doing this now at the end of his life." He's 85 years old. But he said, "I'm doing this to honor those who did not make it back," because he believes those are the real heroes.
And you did this book. Are you doing any follow-ups or anything like that? Has it sparked you to do more?
You know, it's been incredible since the book came out. And I didn't really realize. I mean, when I wrote it, I knew it was a great story and a part of history that needed to be told. But I didn't realize how important it was going to be to other people. And since the book has come out, I've had so many individuals who've been in the resistance or just American veterans who have said, "Thank you for honoring me." And then I've gotten emails from people who have said, "I haven't talked to my dad in 20, 30 years."
Yeah.
And I sent them the book and said, "Dad, let's talk." And they've reconnected as a result of the book, because the book is about a daughter getting to know her father again. It's a reconnection of a daughter and father. So I hope that this book has inspired people. And when I get these notes and letters and calls, that has made this book so worthwhile. And I have an amazing father and an amazing hero. And I hope it inspires other people to look into their own family and realize there's a lot of great heroes out there that deserve to be recognized.
All right. Rita Cosby, thank you. The book, Quiet Hero, and you can find that Barnes & Noble's.
Barnes & Noble's, Borders, everywhere, and you can find it at Youngstown State University. I will be there this morning, and I'm so proud to be here in this community, especially with so many great Polish community. They've been coming out in droves, and they deserve to be honored.
Thank you very much. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be here. Thank you.
Thank you. And now we're going to go over to Rich for your Whitmer's Farm Forecast.
27 minutes.
Elementary maintenance.
Hey, good morning. Welcome back to Daybreak. Look at the time. It's already about 23 minutes past the hour. And coming up, Len, we have an Emmy Award-winning journalist here, and it's not you.
Okay.
Here, you want to show the book off?
All right, here.
Rita Cosby's here. We're so excited about
Rita Cosby. Talk about her book about her dad called Quiet Hero. All right, she was on the Youngstown State campus last night, and she'll be here to talk to us about it a little bit later on. Okay.
Little does Rita know that she is about to go against a cross-examination and an interview like no other.
What?
Rita, he's tough. He's a tough interviewer. Are you ready? Okay, she's ready for it.
All right.
A little cold coming in this morning?
You know what? It is a little chilly. I'll tell you, a little chilly.
Where do you live? Anchorage.
You know what? I live in New York City.
Oh, okay.
And we have actually, in New York City, we have actually had the coldest winter and the most snow on record. But I was expecting to get, you know, I thought maybe a little sunshine. Someone told me, I think they said it was Youngstown, Florida.
There is a Youngstown, Florida.
No, I'm delighted to be here.
Oh, thanks a lot, Rita. We can't wait for your interview. Hey, good morning. Welcome back to Daybreak. Let's get outside. It is...
TV.
Good morning, everybody. 43 minutes after the top of the hour. Time to bring back Jim Lowboy, weather update. And coming up in a couple of minutes, Rita Cosby to talk about a book about her father she wrote called Quiet Hero. All
right. That's it.
Rita's waiting over in the wings.
How you doing,
Hey,
Rita?
How you doing?
To be with you guys. I can't wait.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
I think she's been on television a couple times. She seems very very relaxed.
Relaxed.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. She's an Emmy Award-winning journalist. My bad.
Yeah, for the record, you guys, I learned everything from you. So thank you for teaching me all these years.
That's right. And she's been on, Fox News and MSNBC. Boy, talk about different ends of the political spectrum. Ooh. Wow.
If ever Len was going to have an autobiography, it wouldn't be Quiet Hero. It would be Quiet Excellence. Because he's so humble.
Thank you.
Let's get to weather because we want to talk to Rita about this fantastic book. Let's get outside. It's really, really cold. Temperatures right now, 22. Chance of some light snow on Saturday. Then we get warm. Even some rain showers for Monday. A nice couple of days, Tuesday and Wednesday, and thankfully, warmer than normal.
Fine. Thank you, Jim. You know, the very youngest World War II veterans now are in their early 80s, and they're leaving us very quickly. And many of them have never talked about their experiences until now. And with us this morning is award-winning TV journalist Rita Cosby. Mm-hmm. All right. Good morning, Rita. Thanks for joining us.
It's great to be with you guys.
Thank you. Thanks for getting up early and coming in. It was written a book about
your father.
And thanks
a lot for making it 7 degrees today. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Or should I blame it on Jim?
Let's blame it all on Jim. Wrote a book about your dad called Quiet Hero, and you discovered that your father, well, my father and all my uncles served in World War II Europe to the Pacific, all right? And they talked about it on and off. Your dad never did, and your dad actually served behind the lines in Poland, in occupied Poland the whole time.
It's an incredible story. And like, you know, your dad and so much of that greatest generation, my dad was very humble about what he went through. And I think part of it also, it was so painful to Len, because it was such an emotional time. He was a young child. He was 13 years old and literally standing outside with his father, saw the planes hovering above, thought it was an air show. And his father said, oh, isn't it great the Polish Air Force is doing exercises? My father said, wait, the planes are coming from the other direction than the air base, and the next thing they know, the bombs are dropping on Warsaw. And these stories of the Polish resistance are so just heroic and so gutsy, literally at points fighting with Molotov cocktails and sticks, down to bayonets, two weapons, and a full unit of about 150 men. Fighting against the Nazi war machine.
Now, Poland pretty much disappeared as a nation under German occupation and then under Russian occupation afterwards.
Yeah, they were squeezed from both sides. And that's the thing. You got to think of what a bad day it must have been. My father and his father are fleeing from this new enemy called the Nazis. They're heading towards then the Romanian border. And then suddenly they get wind that the Russians are coming from the other direction. It's a pretty bad day when you got to decide, do I go to my arch enemy at this point, the Russians, or this new enemy called the Nazis? And they went back towards the Nazis. And then my father became a full-blown fighter. One of the most amazing things, I think, Glenn, about this story, and the story is not just to honor my dad, but it's to really honor all these amazing quiet heroes, not just Polish, but also Americans. My father, at the age of 15, he could have left. And instead, he said, I am staying and fighting for freedom. I would rather die with friends than live with strangers. And he decided to stay and fight.
How did he get out to America then?
Well, my father first was captured by the Nazis, eventually taken to a POW camp, escaped, 90 pounds, 6 feet tall. He escaped. He was in the woods, and a plane came by. They thought it was a German plane, and it threw something out. They thought it was a grenade, and they dove for the ditches, 90 pounds again and 6 feet tall, starving. Turns out the plane came by again, they looked up, and they saw a star, and they realized it was an American plane.
The white star in the wing.
The white star, a note was dropped out, a chocolate bar with the note wrapped around it with the red ribbon. It's my favorite part of my dad's story, and it basically said, you have 15 miles to walk and you're free. So my dad ran to American troops, and at that point my father said, I want to come to America because it is the greatest country in the world, and he wanted to come and give back, and part of the proceeds from the book are going to wounded troops and their families, because this is an opportunity for my dad to give back and an opportunity for me to honor those incredible men and women. And I know here even in Youngstown, you guys have a veterans monument, which is hoping to be moved. I know a lot of people believe it should be moved to Peterson Park, you know, to a new park, to Poland, Ohio, because it's so important to honor these veterans.
Let me ask you this. What advice would you have for families today who are welcoming home their own quiet heroes from Iraq and Afghanistan?
And I think, first of all, go after them with a lot of love and compassion. It is astounding the amount of people, an amount of men and women suffering from post-traumatic stress. It's believed that 800,000 men and women coming back from Iraq and Afghanistan will have some form of post-traumatic stress. I believe my father had it. That's why he didn't share the story for 65 years.
Wow.
He did not go back to Poland until about a year and a half ago. It had been 65 years, almost to the day. He left
back
at gunpoint.
To a free Poland now.
Back to a free Poland. So my advice as a loved one is to reconnect, talk to your, you know, those folks that you love. Talk to them. It's your brother or your father, your sister, whoever is over in battle. Let them know also that there's places to go to help, and let them know it's important to share that story. And I hope that all of them share their stories, because there are so many great quiet heroes out there. And since my book came out, I tell you, some of the most wonderful moments have happened. I've gotten letters and emails from people around the country, and from some people I don't even know if they're in the military, who've said, you know what, I didn't talk to my dad for 20 or 30 years. There was this disconnect with us, and I sent him your book, and now we're talking.
Good.
So to have that is a wonderful gift, Len.
It's ironic. Your dad fought the Nazis in Europe. My father-in-law was in the Luftwaffe.
Oh, interesting.
Now, and we're both friends. How
well, well, I don't know about that. Should I say I'm a friend?
Maybe we can co-anchor.
Jim, right. Should I say I'm a friend? I'm not sure.
Thank you,
Rita. No, it is. It's amazing how history has changed.
It is.
And it's amazing also that I think it's wonderful that we are honoring those people who have made the ultimate sacrifice. And especially now, here we are, we have to remember that freedom is not free. We still have so many men and women in dangerous parts of the world and who are putting their lives on the line. And I hope that this is a great tribute, you know, to your relatives too as
Thank you, Rita. Quiet Hero, available now.
Thank you.
Now, time to bring you up to date on technology news and trends this morning. Want to make a confession? The Catholic Church has an